Hi, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to Wild Wednesdays Live. We're so excited. We have a great lineup today, but I want to just cover a couple of things first. One, if you ever miss a live Wild Wednesday, you can always watch it on our YouTubes. And don't forget to check out the specials on our Quilt Craft Sew Mall. So if you have any questions during the program, you can always type them in and the vendors or speakers will get back to you as soon as they can after their interview. So I want to just go right ahead and turn it over to, I'm so excited, Monica from Quilt and Bead Creations. Monica, are you there?
I'm here. Can you see me?
No. No, it's okay. Not you. Almost.
So how do I
there you are. Around? I see you.
There, how do I turn it around, Beth?
You're good. That's you now.
Okay.
Well, hit your reverse button on your device. There should be a reverse button.
A reverse button
yeah.
on the device.
Yep.
Okay. I'm going to reverse it. I hope.
Yep. So for those of you watching, we might not be so technical or techy, but we're amazing quilters, crafters, and sewers. And we're doing our best in this crazy COVID time to learn all the technology so that we can present it and bring it to you since you can't come to us. Okay. All right, there you are, Monica. Well, it's amazing to see you.
I have someone holding the camera, so I'll just have to tell her where to put it. So, hi, thanks for having me. I'm Monica from Monica's Quilt and Bead Creations out here in Palm Desert, California. And a big thank you to all of you guys who put this on that help us out because we really need it during this time. So what I'm going to be showing you is I'm going to show you these things over here. These are all the bags that I demo at shows. So you want to just show, so you're going to have to look at this. Look, watch and hold it. So these are bags that I demo at shows. This technique that I'm going to show you now is using your favorite piece of fabric. All of these bags that are on this table are showing you your favorite piece of fabric, and you're going to use foam. So these are the little Poppins bags. These all pop up. They have a little piece of wire inside here. So we're going to go over to my table and I'm going to demo how to do this. I'll just tell you where it is. Okay. So instead of using the rope, the 2.5 inch, you're going to have to turn it this way. So sorry that we're new at this. Instead of using the 2.5 inch strips that we used to do, and we used to sew them all together end to end so that you have one long piece of rope. Instead of doing that, like I said, we're going to use our favorite piece of fabric. So whether it's the fabulous cork that's out or whatever fabric you like, this is how you're going to do this. Most of the bags that I have here, you take 3 layers of foam. The foam that we use is double-sided fusible foam from Basel. You use 3 layers of foam. You're going to take your fabric and you're going to lay it onto the foam front and back. You're going to take your pencil and draw an inch grid going across your fabrics. Once you've done that, you're going to stitch on those inch lines. She does show you where to stop and start so that you don't have any shifting of your fabrics. And then you're going to go back and stitch between those lines. So now you have a 1/2 inch grid stitched up on one piece of fabric. This is a beautiful basket. One piece of fabric, all stitched up. Channel stitching is how we call this, using just your favorite piece. Once you have that done, you're going to take it, you're going to square it up just like you do a quilt. Then you're going to take it and stitch on a binding just like you do a quilt. So here's your long piece. You'll fold it. You're going to get your bottom, and I'm going to show you how to make the bottom in a moment. The bottom has two layers of Craftex. We do have pre-cuts for that in all of our sizes. There are pre-cuts that we sell. They're on our website. You're going to take the two layers, and the top layer is the one that you whip stitch on by hand. So you'll whip stitch this onto your bag by hand. So it will look like this. So see how it's, one is whip stitched on and the other one is not. All of the bags that I'm going to show you right now are done using this technique. Some of them use only two layers of foam, but most of them use the three layers. So this is one of the bags here. This is a huge, huge carry-all bag. I don't know if you can see that, but it has lots of rooms. And this is using the foam also. Then we have our big poppins. The poppins is the first one that we did. This we made to fit a featherweight sewing machine. So it does open and close like a medicine bag or a carpet bag. This will fit in the overhead compartment of the plane, but most people wanted it to go underneath the seat. So she came out with what we call the little poppins. And this has two sizes in it. And I'm going to walk over this way. These are the two sizes of the little poppins. They're the same bottoms, but they just have a different height. This is the one, whoops, this one is the one that will fit perfectly underneath the seat of an airplane. And she also came out with what we call the mini poppins. Once again, you can see how it opens and closes nicely. This also has the metal in it. We do have all of these patterns up on our website. And then this is another bag that is the same technique, just one piece of fabric channel stitched. And this is called the perfectly practical bag. So lots of bags using this technique. We went a step further and we started using our cork. We have beautiful cork that is the same technique, using just channel stitching, but the beautiful cork designs. We have sunflowers, we've got little chickadee birds. We have my favorite, which is of course the cactus. Beautiful cactus cork fabric. And these are up on the website also. And these are just some of our samples using that technique. So now don't be afraid. You too can make a beautiful basket or handbag using double-sided fusible foam and two or three layers of the foam to make the basket stand up nicely. I did want to go around the room because we do have our special that we're offering. And it's the 30% off our Halloween and Christmas. So we've got some of our kits up here. And these will be up on the website. This is another one here. This is just a panel we sold out of our truck kit. We're kind of sideways. This is a one that we only have the panel left. This is another Christmas one. So Avelia's going to show you all of our Christmas kits that are available for you. This is your last chance to get them. Okay, so another thing we have is we have kits available, interfacing kits available for the bags that you just saw. And those are available on the web. So you do need your pattern. You need your pattern that has the metal stays in it. Can you see the metal stays in there? But this is the interfacing kit. So this would be the handles here. Your nice firm bottom is here. And then your foam is here. So we do have all of these available on our website. over here, we also have the old technique. We have patterns available for these baskets also that do use the 2.5-inch strips, if you're so inclined into making 120 feet of this. So I think that's all we have for today, Beth. Thanks for joining us.
All right. Thank you, Monica. It was so fun to see you. You know, it's one of those things that's kind of crazy where we don't have shows. And so, you know, we just see each other every month or every couple months. Yep. And now we don't have shows. So it's kind of like a family reunion when I get to see you guys. So, thank you for joining us. And we will see you soon.
Okay.
All right. Stay safe. Thank you, Monica. All right. So there's a couple of things I want to remind you guys. Definitely go to the Quilt Craft Sew Mall to check all of the vendors out, even vendors that aren't necessarily this week, the ones that have been interviewed in the past and the ones that will be interviewed in the future. That's just kind of a great place where you can see all of the vendors from the Quilt Craft Sew Expos. And I want to just let you know, I'm not going to give you the word yet because I know you're all waiting for the special word. I'm not going to give it to you yet, but I'm going to tell you, we have the grand prize today is the Oliso Travel Iron by Michele, a $25 gift certificate toward Monica's, a telephone wire basket from Gary, and a bundle of 8 all Cape Facet fat quarters from Lori. And then we have a set of 3 patriotic digital panels from Raylene, Quilter's Notions. So we've got quite a few giveaways, so stay tuned. Our next speaker is going to be Gary Bond from Global Marketplace. Are you there, Gary?
Yep, I'm here.
Welcome. How are you?
Good. We're doing fine, Beth. We're enjoying the nice warm weather out here in California.
Oh, perfect. Perfect.
No snow. It's like spring out here.
Yeah. Weather has been kind of crazy. It's been gorgeous.
Yes. Okay. Well, thank you. We'll take it from here. Let me get the computer down a little bit. There we go. I wanted to introduce my wife, Jan. Many of you probably have seen Jan in the booth with me at the Rusty Barn Quilt Shows. And Jan will be talking about butterfly jewelry in a few minutes, and I'll be talking about this wonderful Compton necklace in just a few minutes. But what I wanted to start talking about were telephone wire baskets. Many of you have probably seen these in our booth at shows. They're made out of electric wire. They're hand woven. You can see, when I hold it real close to the camera, you can see the detail of how a member of the Zulu tribe in South Africa has hand woven these baskets. They use a mold, and the mold in this case is a tuna can, where they put the wire around that can, then remove it, of course, when they're done. This one's only $20. There's a selection of these on our website. They come in a triangle shape. Here's one that are very good for bobbins and threads and little things like that. If you are not a sewer, a lot of people use these to put the change in or jewelry on their nightstand at the end of the evening. You can also wash them with soap and water. So these telephone wire baskets can be used for food if you would like to, for nuts or something like that. They are not today made out of real telephone wire. They actually have ran out of that years ago. So the Zulu tribe in South Africa actually makes these out of wire that they have custom made. So nobody's taking any wire they're not supposed to take anywhere. You can look at this pattern. It's quite incredible, the detail that they go into, here we go, to be able to make these wire baskets. They start on the rim, and here's the rim right up here, and they weave down to the bottom, and then they tie it off down at the bottom, and they make up that pattern as they go along. Now they come in larger sizes. Here's one that's just black and white. All of these are on our website. This is the actual basket that you would get if you are interested in taking a look at these today, as is the case with the other baskets I'm going to show you. You can see all the detail that's in here when the person weaves the basket. This one is a small bowl. It's only $35 on our website. Here's another small bowl. It's a different kind of pattern, a different set of colors, more of a Southwest kind of theme. When we do two shows in Phoenix and Tucson, these are the most popular styles because they really go with the desert out there. Then they also come in square shapes. Here's a square one. This one's purple. A lot of people really love purple. I think maybe they were royalty in a past life, and so they really like the purple. The copper you see in here is actually real copper, and it's been coated so it won't tarnish. You can see right up here is a little bit of the there it is, a little bit of the real copper. So this would be stunning just sitting on your coffee table, something like that. Here's another example of the different colors. I think they call this color scheme emerald. It's a very pretty greens and blues. To give you an idea of how big they are, well, here's a regular pin. It's not real big, but we do have them in larger sizes. This one is also, this one now we're getting into $40 for the ones that are this size. Here's another example of the color schemes that they come in. This one uses ocean colors and a little bit of a green, light green, to make your decor work. And if you're lucky enough to win our door prize, you can tell me the kind of colors you'd like. And if we have that basket, we'll certainly try to send that on to you if you're the winner. Here's another one of these that's called Earth Rainbow. And you can see that it's got all the colors of the rainbow, but they're muted. They're like Earth. And look at that intricate pattern. I'll hold it up real close. And you can see the artist that made this wove it very tightly. They are members of the Zulu tribe in South Africa that are able to stay on their tribal lands because they have this project. It's a fair trade project. They're paid about four times the normal wage to do this in South Africa. And we work directly with their representative, who's in actually New Mexico. Here's a larger bowl. Now, this one is $57. And you can see it called Black Rainbow is the color pattern here. And it's got a lot of bright blue in it, too. We have a lot more sizes, but and if we have time, I'll show them to you. You get the idea. Just let me look under Zulu telephone wire baskets in our website. I'm going to turn it over to Jan now. You probably remember, if you've seen this, it shows that we have jewelry made with real butterfly wings. So I'm going to turn it over to my wife, Jan. She'll talk about that.
Hi, everybody. We miss coming to shows and seeing you all, but I guess this electronic version we'll have to do for now. I want to tell you a little bit about the butterfly jewelry that we offer. We have pendants like this, and necklaces as well. The butterflies are not harmed in the making of the jewelry. They're raised on a butterfly farm. Let me see if I go this way. Yeah, that's better. The butterflies are raised on a farm in the Amazon in Peru by some indigenous tribe called the Shipibo, and they are able to make a living without hurting their properties by deforesting it and so forth. So it's a really wonderful, sustainable project. They let the butterflies live to lay their eggs and live out a normal life. And then after the butterflies have passed on, the tribe goes out and picks the butterfly wings and dries them. And they transport them to a small workshop in Lima, Peru, where the jewelry is made. And the cool thing about these is that they're double-sided. This one is called a Kramer's 88. And you can see a little bit, the two markings there kind of look like eights. But the cool thing is that they put the reverse side of the wing on the back of the jewelry. So it's like you're getting two for one. This is a very dramatic one in the back, on the back.
$39.
And it's $39. Yes, this is what we call a large pendant. And I'll show you a small pendant. We have one here. These are $29. And all of our pendants come with an 18-inch silver-plated chain. And the findings on all the jewelry are silver plated as well. That keeps the cost down, except the ear wires are sterling, so they're hypoallergenic. Now this one is actually two butterfly wings together. The top part is called a blue morpho, from a blue morpho butterfly, and it shimmers. It's really beautiful. The bottom part is kind of a light green and gold, and it's called malachite. And most of the jewelry on the back is light brown or a dark brown, because this is the underside of the wing, where when the butterfly closes the wings, the side that is visible to predators doesn't make them look very tasty. So, but this is a lovely darker gray color, and sometimes you can see a little eye. I don't know if you can see this too well. Ah, where am I going? There. You can see the eye. That's actually part of the wing. And again, it's to help them not be eaten by predators. We have different shapes as well in the pendants. This one is a small, that one was $29. This one's also $29. This is called a turquoise emperor butterfly. It's got a nice shimmering quality too. It doesn't really show up as well as in person, but it's just beautiful. And on the back of this one, it's a real light color with some beautiful markings. Let me see. There we go. You can see the little markings and stuff. So you can wear these either way. We have a large pendant too in that same wing shape. This one's called malachite, and it's a lovely light green and gold, like the other one that I showed you, the teardrop. And on the back of this one, we have a real unusual back. This is where the back is a little bit darker than the front side. So you can mix and match with your different outfits. We also have earrings. These earrings are, the small earrings like this one are $39. Here's a Kramer's 88 again with the black on the back. And you can see that they, let's see. We have sterling ear wires, like I said, and they're just little hook ear wires. You can put little pokey things on the back of them so you don't lose them. But here you can see the eights really well. To me, that sort of looks like an 89, but that's, they're all individual, obviously. We also have a heart shape in the pendant and the earrings. This is the earrings are a really bright, clear blue. And on the back of this is, this is a blue morpho. On the back of this, you can see the section of the little eyes that sometimes show up on these. There we go. So they're very unique. It's and the group that makes these are able to make a living and have their keep their way of life going in the jungle and maintain their properties. This is another one. Let's see. This one is a large earring set. These are $49. This is a green banded urania, and you can see it's got light green and dark green, a little black, very striking. And if that's kind of the jazzy side, and then the other side is more of a black and a lighter kind of a light blue. So you really have two for the price of one. It makes it really cool. Here's a large teardrop. It's also the malachite and the blue morpho. So they're all, we have all these online, and we have others as well. This one's a really interesting one. This one is called I can't remember.
Butter color,
yes, sorry. Butter color butterfly. The cool thing about this is, you can't see it too well, but it actually is kind of iridescent, opalescent, and it changes color as you move it. So sometimes it looks a little more blue, sometimes it looks a little more pink or yellow. And on the other side, you don't get the opalescent quality, but what you get is a beautiful pattern, a very delicate pattern on the back that is green, brown and kind of a cream color. So again, you can wear these with lots of different outfits. And the jewelry comes in a little gift box like this, and along with a little information about whichever butterfly you're buying. So this shows you a picture of the butterfly and a little bit about the butterfly and how big it is and where it grows, where it is raised. So it makes a lovely gift. We sell a lot of these during the holidays, and everybody loves them. So they make a really nice present. So
okay, thank you, Jan. Don't go away just yet. Right. I'm going to talk a little bit about this beautiful necklace here. You can see Jan's wearing it. There you go. Yeah. It's called a the necklace. I'm going to show this some samples.
And it's very light. Tell you, it's very light to wear, very comfortable, and you can wear it. You can see it's got a lot of different colors in it, so you can wear it with a lot of different outfits.
Okay, so, and I'll show you a few of those in a minute. Before I forget, we're offering a 20% discount on anything on our website if you shop between now and tomorrow night at midnight, Thursday night at midnight. Just enter the code WW20. That's for Wild Wednesday 20. And if you forget it, just mention on the order that you want the discount, and I'll refund you the 20%. That happened with a couple people last time. Then we'll be able to sell you anything we have on the website. A lot more things are on the website than what we're showing you here. But this Compton necklace, here's another example of one right here. This is actually old saris that have been wrapped, they're cut into little squares and wrapped around a wooden ball, and then there's a little brass fitting in between. And the sari was made with a style in India called Kanta, which is where they use old scraps. It's very much like a quilt. We used to sell Kanta quilts for a while until we couldn't get them. But this is something we can get on a fairly regular basis, and we just got a new supply in. You can see how it's big down here at the bottom, and then it goes smaller here. We've got about 12 different styles on the website. This one, I didn't put the prices on, but they range between $25 and $35 each. And they're fair trade, like everything we sell. The artists are mostly women in Nepal and in India that are out looking for these old saris, they're cotton saris. Yes, not silk, they're cotton saris. Let me give you another example. Here's a different style right here. These are, you can see they're about, I think, this is probably 30 inches, something like that. And because they're wood and cloth, it's like wearing paper beads. It's extremely lightweight. You can see all the beautiful colored beads. Everyone is a little different. You won't get the exact one that's pictured, but you'll get one that's got a nice variety like that. Let me show you. Oh, yeah. They sometimes come very sophisticated with lots and lots of little things. Can you imagine how much time it took a young woman to wrap all these little balls in these little pieces of fabric? But they have been doing it for a long time, and it's a good way to reuse things that otherwise might be thrown in the trash can. Let me see. Here's another style. It's a short and goes from very small to very large, real fast. But again, it's very lightweight. And here's another way of making them very complicated. You can see a multi-strand. Yes, thank you, Jan. So these are something new that we just started with. We started with them at the shows just before we had to stop doing shows, and they sold very well because they're so colorful, they're so bold, and they're very lightweight. So those are called Kantha necklaces, and you can find them at Global Marketplace, Fair Trade Crafts. Everything we sell is fair trade. Everything we're selling is helping women mostly support their families and get a fair wage for what they're doing, and our job is to sell them at the shows. We can't wait to see all of you at the shows when they start up again, hopefully this spring. But in the meantime, we really appreciate Eric and Chris at Rusty Barn and you, Beth, for hosting the show to let us have a chance to communicate with people. We did our first show in December, and it went very well for us. So we're just thrilled that we're able to do it again. That's everything we have today, Beth. So it looks like it's about time to turn it over to the next party. Here's Jan. She'll say goodbye.
Hope we'll see you sometime this year at a real show.
Yes.
For sure.
Yes.
For sure.
Okay.
In person.
Exactly. Okay. Well, and I love that your business helps other communities thrive. That's really exciting, because that's kind of what we're all about, is helping each other. So.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. And they do make great gifts. So everybody, you can go on to the Quilt Craft and Sew Mall. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you again soon.
Yes.
All right. Take care. And thank you. So you can go on to the Quilt Craft and Sew Mall. There is a new section there that you can just click on, and that's going to tell you the specials. The coupon code is WW20. And there is a link in the comments, so you can go right there to that link and get over to the mall, or you can type it in. I just want to go over the prizes again. So I'm going to tell you the catchphrase, because I know you're all waiting for it. We have the grand prize is going to be the Oliso Travel Iron donated by Michele. We have the $25 gift certificate to Monica's. The telephone wire basket that Gary just showed, and you can specify the color, and if he has it, he'll do the best he can to match the colors you're requesting. And a bundle of 8 all K facet fat quarters. And then Raylene from Quilters Haven Just Notions has donated 3 patriotic digital panels. So the word that you're waiting for is Wild Watcher. So Wild Watcher, kind of like Wild Wednesdays, but Wild Watcher. Just type that into the comments and you'll be entered into the drawings. You have till midnight tomorrow to email us your information so we can get that out to you. And our next interview is going to be with Michele Muska from Oliso. Are you there, Michele?
I'm here.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm great. Hi. How are you? Thank you
Pretty
for
good.
Having me on. This is
yes.
wonderful.
Yes.
And I have to say, Global Marketing, their business model is just phenomenal, and their products are great. What a wonderful thing that they're doing for all of those communities. So
for sure.
Yeah, really nice. And it's pretty funny because I have one of Monica's bags that she showed me that I'm going to show you how great it is paired with the mini iron. And that way you can order the pattern from her and order the iron from us.
So, perfect. Yeah. You know what? It's really amazing how small and connected our community yeah. is. Yeah.
So I'm the All director right. of content from Oliso. So, and I'm here in my home studio in Connecticut where it's really cold. So.
Oh gosh. Well, the rest yeah. of us are enjoying sunny weather. Yeah. All right. Well, take it away. Okay. Show us what you've got.
Yes, I will. Okay. Hi everybody. This is the pink mini iron that is going to be in the giveaway. So it's Wild Watcher. So make sure you put that in your comments so you'll possibly win. And it will come in a box like this. So I have my husband, Dan, here for just a minute. And he's going to try to bring the camera down a little bit so I can get in close to show you all the features and benefits. A little more, Dan. Okay, that's good. All right. I think that's probably pretty good. Can everybody see that, I hope? So the mini iron comes with its own silicone trivet, and it matches. So I have the purple one hanging up, which you might have seen behind me. So it comes in purple, pink, and butterscotch. And we also have one in turquoise, which I have in a Yazzie bag, which I think Yazzie will be on next week. So, and this is the turquoise. And I love the turquoise one, I think, because some of my projects have a lot of blue in them, and I like to match them. So the silicone trivet is great for protection as well as travel, and you can hang it so it's very safe, space saving. You pull it off of the back and you flip it over, and that becomes your trivet when the iron is on and hot and you're working with it. So I have one over here that's already on in the butterscotch. It has a water tank, holds about 1/4 cup of water. Here are the windows right here to show you how much water is left. And your steam burst buttons are right here. So it's not continuous steam. It has steam bursts. You let it heat up. It will burst about 5 times. You can do it vertically or horizontally. And then you need to just let it heat up a little bit. It has temperatures just like on your large iron. The low temperature for silk, medium for wool, and your highest temperature is for your linen and cottons. It has an ergonomic handle that you use like this, like a computer mouse. And one of the things that I really love about it is it has a diamond-coated ceramic sole plate. So if you're using fusibles with some of your bags and craft projects, it's a very easy cleanup. And it also has a detailer tip. So if any of you are doing garments, you can actually get this right inside your pockets, collars, and cuffs, right like that. So it also is a travel iron. So it has a dual voltage right here. You take just a little pin and slip it over. So it's 120 and 240. So you can travel out of the country with it. And we will be able to travel again. It has a swivel cord. And what's really great about the mini project iron, it has an 8-foot cord and it really feels substantial. I love to take it to my quilt guild and on my retreats that I go on. And I know that maybe probably later in this summer, we'll be able to start doing that again. So one of the things I want to show you is besides the Yazzie bag that I use, here's the mini Poppins bag that Monica showed you. And I'm going to have to admit that I did not make this. My guild president made that for me. So I would just slip this on. And I'd wind it up. I'll try to do this quickly for you. And I pop it right in here. And one of the things that she did I thought was very clever is she put the that ironing board cover, the silver fabric, right on there. And there you go. So I already have the yellow one turned on. And I use it. And I have a wool pad under here. I like to use that. So the favorite projects that I like to use this on is something that's really tiny. I love English paper piecing to do hexies. I love little tiny curvelets. I just had a little sew along on with these little curvelets. And it's just so great that if you have a big iron and you put this on top of it, you'd never see your project. So it's really a wonderful little companion for your small projects. But I also use them on my big projects as well because I'm so used to it. I've kind of fallen in love with it. So I love English paper piecing. And these are the traditional hexies that I have with Liberty of London fabric. And you know that when you have a nice crisp edge with your English paper piecing and you pull the papers out, that's always helpful. And the other thing that I do is I like to use the Roxanne's glue basted. And I basted some already here and it is heat activated. So I would just run this along here like that. And again, it's so wonderful because the iron is so small, I can actually see, you know, what I'm doing. Okay, there. And then it's also really great for, you know, opening up your seams. Or pressing them to the side. I don't know if you all use a wool pad. I have this one that is about 4 feet long and it covers my whole workspace and I really love it. And as I said, it's really wonderful for fusibles too. I have some heat and bond here. I'm working on a little wool felt project. And so if I would happen to get A on this, on my sole plate, you know, it just wipes right off so easily after it cools down. So this whole quilt that I made here, let me see if I can move it over without knocking everything over. I'll put this down. I think I have a few more minutes. This is my Brimfield Awakening quilt that I made for my granddaughter. And I, it's all English paper pieced. And I did all the heat sensitive glue basting on this, which I thought was really helpful when I was applying them onto the blocks. So I hope that I kind of ran through all the features and benefits of our cute little mini irons. And I have to say, they also have the cute factor. Don't we all as quilters love the cute factor? You can go to our website, www.oliso.com. You can find all the features and benefits there. I will give a coupon code, a discount code, which is WW10. It will give you 10% off the cost of the iron, as well as free shipping till tomorrow night at, I think it's 11:59 Pacific time, because our company is located on the West Coast. So once you're at our website, I hope you'll sign for our newsletter. That's also attached to our blog and our YouTube channel. So I hope you'll visit us there. And I think, let's see. Oh, I'm almost ready. So I think I'm pretty much done. I'm so thankful for joining you today, and I hope to see you again. And I also get to show you my new glasses that I just got today. So they're like blue cat eyes. And
I know, those are pretty cute.
My first pair of glasses when I was in third grade were smoky blue cat eyes. So it's a perfect full circle. So, so thanks, Beth. And bye, everybody.
All right. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I love the Oliso irons. I actually have the purple one. I have about three of them. But I have to have the one that raises up and down, because before you had the silicone mat, I used to burn everything because I forget to raise it up and down.
Oh, yeah.
It's a blonde thing. You got to use all the devices and things that help you out.
That's right. That's yes. Right. So thanks again.
Thank all right. you. All right. We'll see you soon. All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, so we I want to remind you, Wild Watcher is our secret code for today. And if you are a winner, it will be posted onto the website on our Facebook page. But you need to claim it by midnight tomorrow night. And if you send Raylene an email and you don't get any response, post it on the comments, because she does check those, and you might have the wrong address or something. So our next person is, well, make sure you visit the Quilts Craft Sew Mall, because that's where you're going to be able to get the 20% or whatever discount. The vendors are all doing whatever discounts work for them, because we all have different products. We all have different, you know, everything's crazy. So I want to go right to Lori from All About Color Quilts. Hi there. How are you? Oh, hi, my gosh. Babe. I love that quilt behind you.
Oh, I'm so glad. It's my brand
amazing.
New one.
It's amazing. Oh, all right. Tell us about it.
It's our brand new, I call it Herb Garden, even though the pattern is Rosemary and Thyme from Cotton Street Outfitters. Anyway, it's all Kate Fassett, the new ones, on a grunge background in the color Aruba. I think it just looks like a modern herb garden. So
yes.
That's what I called it. And I put the most glorious Philip Jacobs fabric on the back. That is turquoise coleus.
I love you. Yes, I love your booth. It's like eye candy.
It is. And I miss being at shows and seeing everybody and bringing my quilts. So I'm glad to have the opportunity to bring them here today.
Well, thank you.
Do you want to see some quilts, Beth?
Yes, I do. I want to be inspired. Okay, take it away.
Here goes. I just took this off the machine, doesn't even have a binding. Every year I kind of make a new blooming nine patch because I fall in love with some Philip Jacobs floral. This time I fell in love with Luscious in Okra. There's really only a little bit of okra, mostly it's periwinkle blue, and I adore it. So I pulled colors from that quilt to make a blooming nine patch. And this is the very latest one. I put purple fern on the back, nice and toned down, and then I'm going to bind it with blue diamond stripe. So it'll be pretty. It makes a really big quilt, like 73 by 90 something. So nice big quilt. Kits for that are on the website. I'll be making them up here in the next day or so, and they are $139. Let's see what else I've got. I made this a couple of months ago, and then as luck would have it, the lemons on the trees started to come into ripen. So I was able to photograph it underneath a tree filled with lemons. I took every citrus colored fabric from the Cape Facet Collective, and I put them together in this little broken hexagon. And what really started it was I had three bolts of this sunburst fabric that wasn't moving. Guess what? It's almost gone. And then I put this luscious in pink on the back. I don't know why it's called pink. It's really all the citrus colors also, but it's almost like a second quilt. Bound it with woven stripe and gooseberry, which is lime and turquoise. It's just glorious. I love this. You might have, if you bought a kit from me, you know that when I put a kit together, I put together instructions and tip sheets. And here's the tip sheet for this one, details about how I did it with photos. And then I have often I'll make notions for a kit. So for this one, I made these, oh heavens, I can't open that. I made these templates so that the cutting is really easy. And for the centers, I like freezer paper foundations. There's a tutorial on the front page of the website, All About Color Quilting, that also talks about how we use the freezer paper prepared method. My glasses really reflect in this light. Hopefully you can see everything and I'm not blinding you. But that is citrus starburst. You can get it with or without the backing. There are about 10 kits left of that. Okay. This one, it's been a pattern I did in about 2006 or 7. I almost always done it in red, but this year, so many beautiful blues came along that I did it in blues. And it's really, really a blue statement. It was originally called Candy Queen. So I call this one Candy Queen Blue. And it self-borders because you put the dark fabrics to the outside and the light fabrics on the inside. So it's kind of a big color wash, all striptease, straight lines. Love doing that. That is Candy Queen Blue. The sunshine makes it look yellow, but it's really a lovely blue. I like to do some fun, easy quilts and inexpensive as well. And this would be one of them. Makes very judicious use of the fabric. This is called, I called it Carnival Stars, based on a little pattern from, I forget the pattern. Anyway, there's a pattern which was originally called Ombre Carnival. I call it Carnival Stars, but it's also a color wash of yellow, red, pink, purple, blue, fun, straight lines, some half square triangles, and boom, it's together. Carnival Stars. Another easy one. This one just looks like a field of tiger lilies. Very simple pattern from Rosa, Villa Rosa, called Duet. Two strips make a block, bunch of blocks. I chose all orange and green for this one. You don't need to see my face. And that is on the website on sale too. So I got to make room for other stuff. I don't do all big $100 or $200 kits. Sometimes I do little wall hangings for $35 or $49. And this would be one of them. Ornamental. What's really fun is I got to do some fun quilting on this one. So when I do hang it on the wall, it will have some texture and interest. That is ornamental. And then I like to do Jane Spillar patterns. She's a young woman from Minnesota, very artistic. And this is her dazzle. Isn't that fun? I used a background that has a metallic thread in it, so it really does sparkle and dazzle. I have to photograph it with that blue quilt on the bed because I think it would look really pretty together. Okay, Tree of Life is one of my favorite designs. And this is our Tree of Life with a mustard background. very fun. A little fussier than some of the other ones. This is our piece de resistance this year. It's called Paradise of Birds. And you'll see why in a moment. The kit has 68 different fabrics in it. So all those birds have all those little pieces with some really fun fussy cutting. And as I usually do, I take the pattern and write a tip sheet so that you have a little bit of extra information about putting it together. And then, like I'll often do, I have some notions created. They're in here. And of course, I can't put my hands on them. But you see all these pieces that are repeated, all these leaf shapes and all these circles and all these little squares. So I have acrylic cutting templates and either heat resistant template plastics for the circles or freezer paper foundations for the others so that you have the tools that you need all in one kit for this. That is Paradise of Birds, and that is the kit for Paradise of Birds. And then of course there's pattern doesn't fit in the bag, so that's separate. There's the gorgeous backing that I used on this quilt. Again, I'm hooked on that coleus fabric. This one is coleus gold. I don't know how he names his colors, but that's not for me to know. This is Big Blooms, another Australian designer. We have so much fun with those crazy Australian designers. Don't tell them I said that. But this is Big Blooms from Wendy Williams. And we had a lot of fun making those. Those are a hoot. My favorite one is this black one right here. I just think it's wild. And we backed that one with tiddlywinks in contrast. The background is that hydrangea fabric, hydrangea spots. You could just barely see the spots in it. Okay, what else? Oh, this is one of my favorites. Again, a color wash, very simple, squares and half square triangles. Couldn't get any easier. How cute is that? Color dive. And Kim McLean, we used to have a love affair with Kim McLean. This is one of her older patterns called Pine Trees. I modified the pattern so that I could show off the big florals and we could once in a while fussy cut a big flower in there. So I made changes and that's all in my tip sheet. What else? This was from last year's Quilts in the Cotswolds. Of course we modified it. We often do. We changed the center and used some hexagons. And also changed the inner vine border and used hexagons. Very pretty, rich color, rich green, chartreuse color, I should say. Love that quilt. And lastly, this one is also from Quilts in the Cotswolds. It is Autumn Chintz. And I just have a few of these left, but it's every autumn toned fabric that you can find in the Cave Collective. And as he likes to do, just a great big giant color splash. Love that quilt too. Of course, we've got all 600 bolts of the Cave Facet fabrics on our website, kits. Here's our free 8 fat quarters, which is gonna be a really fun, be sure to get your name in for that. I see there's glare, but that is gonna be a great project starter. I have all the pre-cuts that you can want from the Cave Facet Collective, and I have these great big project starter bundles on the website. So don't forget to go to the website, see what we've got, and enjoy yourself while you're there. Reach out to me if you have any questions, and thanks for joining my little quilt show this afternoon. It was fun. I miss seeing you in person and hope to see you again at Rusty Barn Phoenix and some of the other California shows too. Thanks.
Perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much, Lori. That was fabulous. It was like our own private quilt show. I love your selection of cape. I do think you have the biggest collection of cape facet fabrics that I have ever seen. So if you are looking for cape, definitely go to the Quilt Craft Sew Mall. And remember that the coupon code is
WW20. 10.
Okay. 10 for your,
one
for
zero.
Yours. Okay.
Yes, 10.
Perfect. Perfect. Okay. All right. So, we also want to remind everybody that you need to, well, we would love for you to share with all of your friends, your guilds, your everybody. We do this every Wednesday at 2 o'clock. And the more you share, the more vendors that we will get to come on here and demo and show us their product. So thank you, Lori, so much for sharing with us. We will see
you
soon.
Thank you, Beth.
Okay, take care. All right, so remember that you have, if you put your name into the drawing, check back, and you will have till midnight tomorrow night to claim your prize. And again, I'm just gonna say, we would really like to thank Raylene for putting all of this together and to making it, for making it happen, and to Rusty Barn, who are the owner sponsors of the Quilt Craft Sew Mall, for making this possible, because us as vendors, we really need all of the avenues we can. And we are so thankful for all of you that are watching and that are going to the mall and checking it out. So thank you. And we will see you next Wednesday at 2 o'clock. Have a great week.